What's up, guys? It's NFL Sports Center. We're going over our NFL playoff predictions for the 2019-2020 season. And of course, it's been a really crazy year. I mean, who expected that we'd be seeing the San Francisco 49ers to be our number one seed at this point of the year? It's really been an awesome season. It's really been a crazy season, and that's for sure. And then even with the Ravens as well. Ravens coming up to the occasion, and they're the number one seed as well in the AFC. But honestly, this, I think, is going to be one of the most entertaining and one of the most interesting playoffs that we've ever seen. Well, that we've seen, at least in the last decade or so. I mean, man, really, looking at this bracket here, most of the teams on here, in my opinion, could make a deep run. With the exception of a couple of teams, but overall, I mean, most of these teams have had really good years, really good seasons, and a lot of them could go very far in the playoffs, and that's why it's going to be so interesting. Nonetheless, we'll be going over my NFL playoff predictions here in this video, and I'm also going to be predicting who I think is going to win the Super Bowl here today. First matchup in the wild card round is going to be between the Houston Texans and the Buffalo Bills. It's going to be in Houston, and this is a pretty interesting matchup. Of course, the Texans last week had a pretty bad loss to the Titans, and that's what got the Titans in the playoffs in the first place. But overall for the Texans, I mean, losing like that at home, it is a little bit concerning, and I think that the Buffalo Bills end up winning that game, and they move on to the next round, probably against the Ravens. As for the Patriots and the Titans, of course, the Tennessee Titans have got a lot of momentum coming in right now. Ryan Tannehill's been leading this group, and he's been doing a really good job. We haven't seen Ryan Tannehill ever play like this, and it's pretty fascinating to see. But as far as the Patriots go, I mean, they lost to the Dolphins last week, so that's that. That's what put them at the number three seed in the first place. So that's pretty concerning for the Patriots as well. I mean, they've lost, I think, three of their last five. But I think in the end, this is a veteran team that the Patriots have. Tom Brady has been very, very experienced, obviously, in the playoffs. And I think that's what gets the playoffs past the Titans. I think, though, watch out for that game. If there is a big upset in the playoffs, I mean, that would definitely be one of them. The Tennessee Titans to take down the Patriots. I would not be stunned to see that happen. But I think the Patriots, though, in the end, get it done. Looking at the NFC side, you got the Eagles and the Seahawks, another really interesting matchup. And obviously, I mean, the Seahawks coming off of a really tough loss against the Niners, that can be a little bit concerning. Just because, I mean, you put all of your effort into that game against the Niners, and having a tough loss like that, just being inches from the goal line to possibly give you the lead and possibly the win, that's definitely a motivation killer for the Seahawks. But I think in the end, Russell Wilson, I've got a lot of faith in him. I think he's a great quarterback. And for the Eagles, really, this Eagles team just has not been all that great this year at all. And I think the Seattle Seahawks, I'd take Russell Wilson over Carson Wentz any day. And I mean, the Eagles, both teams are significantly injured as well. You can't forget that. And so yeah, with that, even though, I mean, injury won't be much of an advantage, I think that the Seahawks end up getting the win there, and they're going to face the Niners in the second round. As for the Saints and the Vikings, I think this might be your most lopsided wild card matchup. I think the Minnesota Vikings, I mean, obviously they were locked in the number six position before week 17, but losing to the Chicago Bears in the way they did, that is a little bit concerning. They also lost to the Packers in week 16. You can't forget that as well. I think the Saints roll over the Vikings. I think the Vikings are a complete team, though. The Saints are absolutely on fire right now. They are red hot coming into the playoffs, and it's the right time to get hot, that's for sure. But they really beat up the Panthers, especially in week 17. That was a really good win there for them. And so that's what puts the Saints into the divisional round. As for your divisional round, looking at the AFC side first, you got the Buffalo Bills and the Baltimore Ravens going head-to-head in Baltimore. And this is going to be an interesting matchup as well. Two teams that are pretty unexpected to have such great seasons as they've had. But I think in the end, the Ravens and having Lamar Jackson in there, I mean, that Ravens team is a more complete team than the Bills are. And so that's what gets the Ravens to win there in the end. As for the Chiefs and the Patriots, this is a really interesting matchup, and I hope this one happens. Of course, it's a rematch of last year's AFC Championship game. And that was a great game as well. But I think the Chiefs overall, I mean, the Chiefs are they've got more momentum at this point. I think the Patriots losing three of their last five once again, that's what gets them lost in the end. And I mean, just they've been looking a little bit sluggish as well. I mean, I don't know what's been happening with the Patriots this season, but they really haven't been looking like their usual self. And that's what gives the Chiefs the win in the end. Also with the Chiefs, they've won all of their last five. They won five in a row. And they also Patrick Mahomes, he's been a little bit injured this season. But considering he's getting healthier, he's been looking a lot better as well. And that's what gets the Chiefs the win in the end. As far as the Seahawks and the Niners go, this is going to be your biggest upset probably of the entire playoffs. I'm going to be picking the Seattle Seahawks over the Niners, and it sounds absolutely crazy, but just watch. I think it's going to happen. I think the Niners are, I mean, don't get me wrong, the Niners are a really, really good team. Their defense, everything is really good. But the Niners being at home, I think the Seahawks are going to be really motivated coming into that game. I think they're going to be fired up from how things ended in Week 17, and I think they're going to be very, very motivated, and that's what's going to give them the win in the end. I think we see a huge upset there. Seahawks win. They're moving on to the NFC Championship. As far as the Packers and the Saints go, this is a really interesting matchup too. Very intriguing. With the Packers, of course, being a team that has also been very surprising this year. I never expected the Packers to put up 13 wins this season. That is insane. But yeah, they're going to be facing up against the Saints in the divisional round. And I think that the Saints, I mean, don't get me wrong, the Saints are a great team and all, and I think the Packers are as well. But with the Saints, with having Drew Brees and Alvin Kamara also playing very well right now, I think that's what gives the Saints the win in the end in Lambeau. And even though the conditions may be a little bit tough, you got to consider that Green Bay is way up north, and it's very possible that game could be in a snowstorm. And in that case, I'd probably pick the Packers in that one. But I think the Saints are, once again, they've got a lot of momentum coming into the playoffs. That's what gives them the win here in the end. Coming down to your conference championships, we got the Baltimore Ravens, KC Chiefs, Seattle Seahawks, and the New Orleans Saints. Starting off with the AFC Championship game between the Ravens and the Chiefs. Really good matchup here. Of course, Lamar Jackson and Patrick Mahomes going head-to-head. That will be a classic there. Both those teams playing very well right now. And this could go either way. No doubt about it. I mean, both teams, I think, are pretty similar skill-wise. The Chiefs haven't played as well consistently all season long. But, of course, Patrick Mahomes being injured has had some part of dealing with that. But I think the Ravens, in the end, having home field advantage is what's going to give them the win there. I think the Ravens win against the Chiefs, and they move on to the Super Bowl 54. As for the Seahawks and the Saints, that game's going to be in New Orleans, and it's kind of surprising. That'd be a crazy game with the Saints being the 3 seed and having a home game in the NFC Championship. I mean, that's a 3-5 NFC Championship, I'm predicting. But I think the Saints, overall, with having Drew Brees once again and also having a veteran team, and once again, the momentum leading up to the playoffs is what's going to give them the win. They're going to head to the Super Bowl there as well, and they're finally not going to be shut down by any referees. As for the Super Bowl, Ravens and Saints, really good matchup here. Of course, once again, with Lamar Jackson, excellent quarterback. He's played super well all season long, and the Ravens are absolutely red hot, just like the Saints are coming into the playoffs. But in the end, the Saints having Drew Brees. Drew Brees is going to be really motivated, especially trying to get back to a Super Bowl. And with him being a little bit older as well, he's in his 40s, I think, already. And with that, I think that the Saints are going to be really motivated as a whole, especially with how things have ended the last couple years. And with that, I'm going to take the Saints to win the Super Bowl this season. I think we see a big high-scoring matchup in the Super Bowl between both these teams. And of course, both teams have decent defenses, but their offenses are especially where their teams shine. So in the end, the Saints win the Super Bowl. They finally get what they've wanted for the past couple years, but they've been shut down by referees pretty much. I mean, let's admit it. But yeah, I mean, the Ravens, once again, if it comes down to this Super Bowl matchup, the Ravens, I would not be stunned a single bit to see them win the game. The Ravens are a fantastic team. And in the end, I mean, the Ravens have nothing. If they lose in the Super Bowl, or if they even make it to the AFC Championship game and they lose, there's nothing to be upset about if you're a Ravens fan or if you're a Raven. I mean, man, it's been a really excellent season for that team. Nonetheless, let me know your thoughts, though, on the NFL playoffs in the comments below. Let me know who you think is going to win the Super Bowl. That's very interesting. I mean, obviously, it could be many, many teams in this situation. I mean, the Bills could make it. I wouldn't be surprised. The Ravens easily should. Kansas City Chiefs could. I mean, the Patriots could. I mean, the Titans, even if the Titans pulled something out, I mean, Ryan Tannehill has been really turning this team around, especially in the second half of the season. I don't think the Eagles could, but I mean, the Seahawks, certainly they could as well if they're motivated and if they can get past the Niners. I mean, it's certainly possible. The Packers with their momentum, but having Aaron Rodgers, I mean, really anything can happen. So, like, really any of these teams could make it. So that's why I think it'll be one of the more interesting playoffs that we've seen in recent years. But nonetheless, let me know your thoughts once again. If you disagree with anything here, be sure to let me know in the comments below. I'd like to hear your opinions on that. Once again, thank you all for watching. Be sure to stay tuned for more. We'll be going over some wild card game predictions and previews coming up over the next couple of days, so be sure to stay tuned for that. But yeah, once again, thank you all for watching, and I will see you all later.